Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we'll see how to configure GPIO pins of LPC2148 microcontroller and how to write program with the help of these particular registers for simple LED blinking. So in this lecture series, we are going to cover all these 4 points. Out of these 4 points, we have already covered this introductory part. Then we have covered this pin select register. These pin select registers are basically used to select the different functionality of the pin, because in one pin we are having different functionalities, minimum one and maximum four functionality. So to select one functionality out of these four, we use pin select registers. Okay, now there are another four registers which are available to control the GPIO operation. So whenever we use microcontroller, then we normally define these particular pins as an input or output for performing certain operation. For example, if we want to read sensor values, then we define that microcontroller pin as an input pin, and then we read values. Suppose we are interfacing LEDs or 16 by 2 LCD or another LCDs, then in that case, after interfacing these display devices, we must have to define interface pin as output pin to send signal via these pins. Okay, so these operations or these configurations we can perform with the help of these four registers. So we are going to study these four registers in this tutorial. So there are five fast GPIO registers and four slow GPIO registers available to control the port 0 and port 1. So we are having total 9 registers to control the port 0 and port 1 operations. Okay, now there are 5 fast registers. Okay, they are also called as enhanced GPIO registers, and 4 slow registers. Now these 4 slow registers are compatible, or we can say backward compatible with the earlier family devices. Okay, they are also called as legacy GPIO registers. Okay, so we are going to study these slow registers because they are backward compatible with earlier family devices. Okay, so these 4 GPIO registers are nothing but IO pin, IO DIR, that is direction register, IO set register, IO clear register. IO stand for input output. Okay, so we are having IO pin, IO direction, IO set, IO clear register. Now this direction register, this pin register is used to read the pin of particular micro, to read the particular pin of a microcontroller. Okay, suppose we want to read data available on that particular pin, on particular pin of microcontroller, then we can read that particular pin with the help of this IO pin register. We can also write data on using IO pin register. Now normally pins of microcontroller are defined as an input or output. Okay, so this input output definition is normally done with the help of this IO direction register. Okay, so IO direction register is used to define pins of LPC2148 as an input or output. Then IO set register is used to make particular pin of LPC2148 microcontroller into the high state. Suppose we want to make one pin as into the high state, then this is done with the help of IO set register. And last one is IO clear. This register is used to make particular pin of LPC2148 microcontroller into the low state. Okay. Now here is description of this register. So as I said, IO pin, this particular register is used for both reading and writing data from or to the port. Then IO direction, the GPIO direction control register, this is called a GPIO direction control register. This register individually controls the direction of each port pin. Suppose if we write 0 on particular pin with the help of IO direction register, then that pin will be defined as an input pin. If we write 1, then that pin will be defined as an output pin. Then IO set register, this register controls the state of the output pin. With the help of IO set register, if we write 1 on particular pin, then that particular pin will go into the high state. If we write 0, then there will be no effect. Similarly, This IO CLR, that is input port output clear register, this register controls the state of the output pin. With the help of this IO CLR register, if we write 1, then that particular pin will go into the low state. Okay, so these four registers are very, very important. So for configuring these particular pins as a input or output, we are having three methods. Okay, different methods. So first method is like this, IO0. So IO0 represent input output zero port direction. If I write IO1, then it will select port 1 register. Sorry, port 1 of LPC2148. Okay, here I have written IO0, it means port 0. So IO0 direction is equal to 1 is assigned to pin number 3. So in this case, pin number 3 will be declared as a output pin, because if we assign 1, then that particular pin will be declared as a output pin. Okay, so here we have already studied this concept with the help of direction register. Okay, now in this particular method, if we write this instruction, then in this particular method, 1 is written on this P1.3 pin, whereas other pins are forced to be assigned to 0. Now next method is like this, IO0 direction 0x000008. So this is hexadecimal number. If we convert it into binary, then it will be, I am just writing last 4 bits, which is nothing but 1000. So this is pin number 0, this is pin number 1, this is pin number 2, and this is pin number 3. So port 0.3 pin. So in this case, only pin number 3 will be affected, because in this case, in this method, the hexadecimal value of the register is assigned after ORing the register with itself. In this way, the other pin other than the desired pin is P0.3, are not affected. This method is useful if we want to assign many pins without affecting the other pins. Okay, so in the similar way, we can write instead of F, if we write F, then all lower 4 pins will be assigned as a output pin, because we are writing 1. Okay, so these pins will be considered as a output pin, and we can send signal via these pins. And this is the third method. In this third method is similar to the second method, except only one pin is affected. So in this case, we are having just this symbol as compared to the first method, and 1 is assigned to pin number 3. Okay, so these are the three different methods of assigning particular pin as an input or output. Okay, now we'll see some examples. So IO0 direction is equal to 1 is assigned to 11 number pin. So 11 number pin of port 0 will be considered or defined as an output pin. Then IO set is equal to 1 is assigned to 11 number pin. So in this case, 11 number pin of port 0 will go into the high state. Then making port 0.15 as output, paid port 0.15 high and then low, can be done as follow. So if you want to define port 0.15 pin as the output, then you have to make this particular pin into the high state and low state. Then if we want to perform this operation, then this can be done with the help of these three instructions. So IO0 input output 0 direction, first we have to define that particular pin as output, is equal to 1 is assigned to 15. So pin number 15 of port 0 will be considered as output pin. Then IO0 set. So we have to set particular pin. Which pin? Pin number 15. So 1 is assigned to pin number 15. So it will go into the high state. Again, if we want to put into the low state, then IO0 clear. Which pin? 1 is assigned to pin number 15. So this pin number 15 of 0 port will go into the low state. Now please remember this thing, in both IO set, IO clear or IO direction, in IO set and IO clear, we are writing 1 on that particular pin. So if we write 1 with the help of IO set, then that pin will go into the high state. If we write 1 with the help of IO clear register, then that pin will go into the low state. Okay, now here again we'll take few examples. कॉन्फ़िगर P0.10 पिन, पोर्ट 0 का 10 नंबर पिन एंड पोर्ट 0 15 नंबर पिन एज अ आउटपुट एंड सेटिंग देम हाई. सो IO0 डायरेक्शन, सो दिस इज डायरेक्शन कंट्रोल, इज इक्वल टू 10 नंबर पिन इज असाइन 1 एंड 15 नंबर पिन इज असाइन 0. ओके, सो हियर इज अ OR सिंबल. वी आर असाइनिंग टू पिन और वी आर कॉन्फ़िगरिंग टू पिन एट अ टाइम. Okay, so configure P0.10 and 15 pin as output. We are assigning one to these two pins simultaneously. And then we have to set them into the high state. So IO0 set pin number 10 and pin number 15. We are writing 1-1. Okay, so in this way we can define multiple pins. We can configure multiple pins also. Then configuring first 16 pins of port 0. Suppose we have to configure multiple pins. Okay. So in that case, this is also possible. Configure 16 pins as output and setting them high. So IO0 direction is equal to, I am writing hexadecimal number. So 4 times 0 and FFFF. So these are nothing but lower 16 pins. That is P0.0 to P0.15 pins. And then I am setting into the high state again by putting FFFF. Okay. So this pin will go into the output and then they will go into the high state. So in this way, we can define particular pins as an input and output. We can write high or low signal. Okay, so in this with the help of these four registers we can define certain particular pin as an input or output. Then we can write or we can make that particular pin go into the high state or low state. Okay, now next we'll see one simple LED blinking example, LED blinking program with the help of embedded C programming language. So in this we are going to make port 0, we are going to consider port 0 for LED blinking. So we are assuming that to the port 0 we have connected LEDs and we want to blink all the LEDs which are connected to the port 0. So first line is hash include LPC2148H, then void delay, I am writing one function name and void main. This is my main program. So IO0 direction. So IO0 direction, this register is used to declare particular pin as an input or output. Now as in this example we are blinking LEDs, so we must have to define pin as an output pin. So I am writing IO direction is equal to 0xFFFF. I am writing 1 because I want to declare this particular port as a output port. Okay. And then infinite loop I am writing while 1. Inside this I am going to, first I am going to set this particular pin into the high state with the help of this. So IO set 0. Okay. Or IO 0 set we can write is equal to 0xFFFF. So I am setting this particular port 0 into first high state, then I am applying delay. So whenever we call this delay function, it will come into this unsigned integer I is defined and this I will be executed 30,000 time here. So we'll get some delay. It may be in millisecond. Then after that IO 0 clear or IO clear 0 is equal to 0xFFFF. Okay. So I am again writing or I am again making this particular port pin after applying some delay into the low state with the help of IO clear register. Okay, and then again I am applying delay and as this is while one, this is infinite loop, so it will work in infinite time. So again it will go into the low state, high state, like this you will get square waveform. And if we, this square waveform is nothing but LED blinking, because in this state your LED will be in on state because we are writing high to this particular pins. In this state your LED will be into low state. Okay, so again high state, again low state. So in this case your LED will be in blinking condition. So in this way we can write program. This program is in embedded C for blinking of the LEDs. Suppose we have to select only one pin instead of this all pins of port 0, then we can write instruction like this: IO0 direction. Suppose we want to assign pin number 10, we have connected LED to pin number 10, then we can write like this assign 1 to pin number 10. So configure only pin number 10 of port 0. Okay, and then set that particular pin. Okay, so instead of this and this, we have to write only this particular instruction if we want to make one particular pin as a on off pin, or we want to blink LEDs which is connected to only single pin. Okay, thank you.